Hi everyone and welcome to the Floss Marketing School. Today we are going to study the differences between Matomo analytics and other third-party analytics player in terms of data collection. So it may happen that sometime when you are looking at your stats within Matomo analytics and another third-party player analytics vendor, you may find some discrepancies, and this is what we are going to study today. So if you go on matomo.org, you will see a full page explaining you what are the different criteria you could look at. In the for the sake of this video, we are going to use our own working methodology, or at least the one that I use here. It's not fully complete. I'm going to explain you why. The website that we are going to study is the following one. So that's a nonprofit organization based in France. They have both Google Analytics and Matomo installed. So the first thing that you should do in order to study if there are some potential discrepancies between Matomo and another third-party player, such as Google Analytics, is really to look at the data overall. So for example, here in my case, I started to take like a date range in order to start from the 1st of June to, let's say, the 7th of June. I applied it and I did the same thing for Google Analytics. And what I noticed over here is that there are some discrepancies that we could already notify at the global level. So let's imagine, so we go over here, visitors overview. We're going to see the following stats, right? This is for 1 week period. We have like 845 visits. We have this average visit duration and we have this bounce rate, right? So just take like the biggest metric that you can and do exactly the same thing for the other analytics tool that you are considering. So for example, here, the 1st June to the 7th of June, and I'm still on an overall audience. So here you can see, so I'm about 974 and here I'm at 845. So the difference is not that big over here. Of course, for you, it's big, but let's say when you are comparing one tool to another one, you can expect actually a difference between 10 to 15%, depending on the way that they're measuring visits. And here, for example, if I look at the number of page views, I'm close to 5,000 visits, 5,000 page views. Here, I'm about 2,000 page views. So here you can clearly identify that there's a problem somewhere, right? I mean, the difference is too big. It's not about 10% anymore. So probably there's something wrong. And if you look at the bounce rate over here, it's 56%. And here it's 6.16%. So this is definitely the kind of thing that you want to note somewhere. So here, for example, the first thing I will audit is, let's say, the overall metrics. Do something looks like strange, and then you just highlight the metric which looks like strange to you. So here in my case, the period of reference that I took is the 1st of June, because most of the time when you are playing with Matomo, depending on the server that you are studying, you may not want to play with much data because it's going to tire your website. So in my case, I just took the 1st of June as a point of reference where I noticed actually those data discrepancies on a weekly period. So that's why for the working methodology that I use here, I just took one day. Okay, so here you highlight, you say, okay, this 10% bounce rate for Google Analytics. So that's kind of strange. Here I noticed that for Matomo, the average duration of the visit is very high, because it's 9 minutes and 6 seconds, as you can see over here, and it's pretty high for a visit, so I find it kind of suspicious. And here I need to know actually who is guilty here, because as you can see, this one is like close to twice the one of this one, and it's kind of suspicious. Or this one is suspicious because it's very low. So when there are some huge difference, this is something that you can highlight, because this is definitely where you will dig next time. Okay, next question you need to ask you is which time zone is used. And here it's kind of interesting, because when you are doing like a comparison like this, you're always looking for the guilty one, right? Is Google Analytics guilty, or is it Matomo, and so on and so forth. And it's kind of interesting to see that when you are looking at that kind of information, you find out that actually there are some mistakes in both installations. So here for Google Analytics, you look at the view level, it seems, and here the time zone is France. And if you look in my case for Matomo, if you look at manage, you will see that here the time zone is United States, New York, whereas actually this website is based in France. So definitely here I need to highlight this, right? Because here it means that in any cases, when I will compare the data, I will have like 6 hours of difference, which is already enough in order to screw up all the analysis that I'm going to do here. So it means that here clearly at this given level, I could already stop my audit and modify and put from New York to France, because otherwise the, let's say, the comparison that I will do, everything that I will be biased. So what I will do after this video is I will put it on France and I will add an annotation in Matomo Analytics in order to say, okay, I modified the data, I modified the settings, and I will run in, let's say, 1 week from now, a new audit analysis because the data will be less biased. Then what you could as well consider is the tracking code down. So tracking code down means that actually Matomo or either Google Analytics is not recording any things anymore. So in order to measure that out, you can just go on audience for Google Analytics and look at overview. And for Matomo Analytics, you can just look at dashboard. On dashboard, you click on visitors, and visitor, you look at times, and here you will get actually the time period. So it's per server time. So this one is the one I'm mostly interested in. And as you can see, no data were recorded at 4 p.m. and 21 and 22, 10 and 11 p.m. Whereas here in the case of Google Analytics, oh, as well, it lost actually some data from here to there. So here you can check on Google Analytics website. I have something which is telling you the server is down, but in any cases, I don't have enough visits in order to have those data quite accurate, right? If it was about 100 visits, we're close to zero on one tool and not on the other one, it would be suspicious, but here we are talking about just like 3 to 1 visit, so not enough in order to draw a conclusion here. So this one, I will say that I need more data in order to ensure that there is something wrong from the Matomo side or Google Analytics side. So here it's 21 and 22, not 20. Okay, then other thing that you can investigate is, are those two solutions measuring the same domain? And this is really interesting because when I looked at what Google Analytics is doing, so if you look here at technology and network, you will see that in fact, and I didn't know that, that Google Analytics, if you click here on hostname, is hosted on 3 websites, webassos.org, webassos.fr, and webassos.jimdo, so which represent actually 7 visits. And if I apply here a segment which is saying, okay, hostname is not webassos.org, and if I just apply this given segment over here, right, you will see that I don't have any data at all for this given day. So this is kind of interesting. It means that Google Analytics is installed on webassos.org, but as well on another website, which is webassos.fr, on which Matomo is not installed at all. And as a result, of course, some data are recorded over there, which are not recorded within Matomo, which may end in the difference that we are notifying over here in terms of visits, right? Means that here you need to remove 6 visits out of this one, which make it close to 44. And this one, of course, will be closer to 44, which makes that the data will be a little bit more consistent. Okay, then what are the different pages called? Which one differs? So this one is interesting as well as a criteria. What you can do is that actually you can look at the different pages which have been called. So in my case, pages over here. And you do exactly the same thing from the Google Analytics side. So just go here on behavior and then you click here on its content and all the pages. And you will get, in fact, all the list that you can extract. Okay. You can just put it here at the maximum. So you see that we have 52 entities, whereas actually from the Matomo side, we have like 58 entities. So it's kind of interesting. We have less page view from the Google Analytics side, whereas actually we have more page views in Google Analytics, which are recorded. So it's kind of interesting. What you can do afterward is, of course, a comparison between the two. Oops, sorry for that. You can just extract. Oops. I think it's over here. And yes, you can compare it. This is Google Analytics. This is Matomo analytics, and you can compare, in fact, which URL are missing. And here, in fact, all those URL are coming from webassos.fr, which is the other website. And like this, by comparison, by making the comparison from one URL to the other one, you may identify actually some part of your website which are not tracked in a system and which are tracked in another one, or even sometime when some parameters are recorded and they are not in the other one, and so on and so forth. So it's kind of interesting to run as an analysis. I dislike it because what I dislike in this system is it's going to take you some time, and that's problematic. Then another criteria that you can investigate is look at a couple of visitors randomly. And the reason why I'm asking you this is that, as you can imagine here, you have a bounce rate which is very low. So as it's very low, the way to decrease the bounce rate is to measure events. So that's one thing that you could investigate. So if you look here at Google Analytics, and you see that actually few events in my case have been fired and the bounce rate is still very low, well, it sounds not good at all, because it probably means that actually other actions are fired, and those other actions will be page views. And if you look over here at audience, and if you look at the user explorer, and that you just pick up a couple of users, let's say randomly, let's say like this one, what you're gonna see, you see that this URL has been called at 8:14, and this URL, which is the same, has been called as 8:14. So I guess that what is happening over here is that you have like a double tracking, or at least the same tracking is fired twice. So as a result, the number of pages are multiplied by 2, which cause at the end the bounce rate, which is very low, and the number of page view, which is very high. Okay, so that may be the reason why actually those two indicators are messed up. And here I'm gonna stop my audit, my analysis, because as you can see, I'm playing already with too many variables. I have this thing which is not good at Matomo. I have those things which are not good at Google Analytics. I have those things that I, and it starts actually to be too many variables to take into consideration. So if I continue my audit, I may find actually some other discrepancies which may be dependent of those or even or other criteria which are wrong. So I first need to, let's say, correct all those different criteria, and then once they are corrected, to run another audit in order to not mess everything up, because I may end up with more than 5 to 10 variables and so on and so forth, and that will never end it up. And that's why actually measuring the differences between different analytics software may take you a while and may actually fried your brain. So yeah, be structured, try to define your own working methodology, and always look at the highest possible level. Once more, thank you very much for watching this video. The best piece of advice that I could give you is, let's say, to try to make your own working methodology, right? To have your own grid to look at, where you have criteria number one, criteria number two, because basically what you are going through this time, you may have to go through it another time. Once more, thank you for watching. Do not hesitate to share this video and to create your own video out of it. Thanks.